Foodstory offers small group guided tours of culinary destinations in rural Japan. We aim to introduce you to inspiring locals, delicious regional cuisine, and guide you on a discovery of local flavor. Today, I'd like to introduce a small town called Gujo Hachiman in Gifu. Gujo Hachiman is known for the beautiful stream and communal washing areas throughout the town. My grandmother lives not far from here, and I grew up watching the way she utilizes a stream nearby her home as almost an extension of her kitchen. This town is also known for the Bon Festival's all-night dance for four consecutive days, and attracts thousands of dancers from near and far. This is an event for everyone, including children to elderly. Dance choreography is simple and repetitive that you'll master a few in an hour. I'm taking a Nagaragawa Tetsudo, local train, to Gujo Hachiman, and I'd like to explain how to take the local train. First, hop onto the train and make sure you pick the ticket. This ticket has a number. The lady is now exchanging the money. If you don't have the exact change, you can use a bill to get smaller coins. My ride was about 45 minutes, and I pay a little more than 1,000 yen, about 10 bucks. You can also take a direct highway bus from JR Nagoya Station. This station is one of the biggest stations in Nagaragawa Line, with many coin lockers, a ticketing machine, and even a cafe. One coin breakfast was too enticing that I had my second breakfast here. I couldn't help stopping here as it says, "Dear monkey, please don't eat our vegetables." I chose to walk along the riverside, Yoshida River, which flows into the Nagara River. Many fishermen are here, and they are all going after the fish called Ayu, which is allowed to fish from May to October. The bridge above this river used to be a popular jumping point for the local kids, but you have to know which side of the river is safe to jump in. I'm going to start exploring the left bank of the river first, then take another bridge to explore the right bank. First place I like to introduce is one of the spots every tourist stops by when visiting this town, called Sogisui, the communal washing area. And right next to this spot, this is a very popular Japanese sweets cafe. When I stood here, I regretted that I had the second breakfast at the station. This communal washing area is unique to this region, where neighbors share each washing space to wash freshly picked vegetables from their garden or mountains. My grandfather used to keep fresh caught fish alive in here. I don't think soap use was allowed here, but everything else you wish you could do before bringing your harvest into the kitchen, you could manage to do here. I have to buy a few souvenirs. This is an old candy shop my grandmother likes, so I'm getting what they are known for, kuroniki candy with molasses and cinnamon. Another place I'm stopping by is a miso shop my mother likes. I love they make miso and soy sauce here from the regional recipe using rice, soybeans, and barley. This is one of the streets used for the Bon Festival's all-night dancing. Ivy-covered restaurant I like to check out, and the popular soba restaurant I must try next time too. As you walk around, you might notice these red buckets. It's for the fire. It's usually filled with sand. That's a good restaurant that serves popular regional dishes. It's a small restaurant and makes sense people are picking up their lunch now. This is another part of town and streams. Here you can see the name of the household using the washing space. We take turns cleaning the communal area in Japan, but we are supposed to leave no trash and keep it tidy as it was before. You find this communal washing area along the stream in town, or your house has a stair down to the stream or river. Before my lunch reservation, I like to show my favorite garden in the temple. Not only do I like the unique shape of the wood piece at the entrance, the garden here is exceptional as it sits by the mountains. It also should be one of the few gardens in Japan that has a natural fall. This is where you cleanse your hands, and as you drop water down here, you hear the water drops making echoing sounds like harps. We call this system as a suikinkutsu. Check out this section drawing. A big vase is buried upside down underneath with a hole to drop water that creates the sound as water drops. You'll often see this adjacent to the tea ceremony house. Design metal pieces called kugikakushi to cover and hide the nails. I notice my lunch reservation is coming up in 20 minutes. I'm meeting up with my mother at the restaurant. That means I have to be there a little earlier as she always arrives early. I'm now walking back to the restaurant behind the old city hall. I like this town as I can always find a way to walk along the stream. This is another stream nearby shrine. Used to be a communal washing area too. Now, most of these communal washing places are just kept but no longer served as it used to be. I got to the restaurant a few minutes before and of course found my mother already there seating. The owner renovated an old house into the Italian restaurant located in between the Yoshida River and the communal stream, a perfect place for this town. As expected, the appetizer was lightly fried tender ayu fish, much that I decided to order the pasta dish with ayu and botalga. The main dish is grilled tender pork. As we looked down to the river, my mother saw the fisherman catching a fish. Thank you for watching. I hope to meet you on one of my food story tours in the future.